News brought to you in part by Asheville. Any way you like it. Visit exploreasheville.com and plan your trip today.
If you are just joining us, jury in Davie County finding Dr. Kirk Turner not guilty by reason of self-defense. And we have legal expert attorney, Dr. Carl Parrish here now to provide some insight into this case for us. There's a law in North Carolina, and this law in this case for Kirk Turner worked. So is there a such thing as a legal killing in North Carolina?
Whether we would call it legal or not, there is, to the extent that what everybody's talked about is self-defense. Mm-hmm. In this state, it's very simple, all states, that you first looked at, did the defendant believe that he was getting ready to be murdered, killed himself, or seriously harmed, and that his actions were in response to that. But the bottom line of all of that is all of these actions happen within a matter of seconds, ordinarily, in murder cases. 2 years later, you spend weeks trying to figure out exactly what happened. In addition to his belief, the quote, person of ordinary prudence must then decide, was that belief justified? The prudent person is the jury. So they listen to everything that both sides say. The exceptions to self-defense is, if the defendant was the aggressor, he's not even entitled to that charge to the jury. So when you look at it, the jury's function was very simply to say, in his mind, did he honestly think he was going to be seriously injured, which there was evidence of, or killed? Mm-hmm. Not being the aggressor, not having a deadly weapon when it started, then it's up to that jury to make the decision. But the key is, it was not up to him or his lawyers to prove that. Mm-hmm. The state of North Carolina has a burden of proof beyond a reasonable doubt that it was not self-defense. The foreman of the jury that spoke earlier said the state changed their theory several times during this trial, and they just didn't prove that.
Well, let me ask you this. You know, knowing the relationship with his wife, did Dr. Turner have an obligation to avoid that situation?
Domestic cases in and of themselves can be very acrimonious. And so avoiding it, this email, I've not read the email. It's my understanding that the email was, I need to come by and pick up some of my stuff, and had someone go with him. That would not give the appearance of anger, possibly. Mm-hmm. It's not uncommon in domestic cases, if you're separated, to say, I need to come pick up whatever out of my shop, my clothes, or what have you. And there was, trust me, if there was something that would have shown hatred, I'm going to settle this now, with 23 months worth of work, mm-hmm. and the effort that's been put out there, they would have found that.
And one last question, and quickly, is there something to learn here for all of us that we should take away from this?
Flight or fight is our basic instinct. It's the bottom half of our brain. If you can avoid it, get away at all costs. But if you're in that position that you can't, you have to protect yourself or your children or your family. But always understand, if a death occurs somewhere, over a period of time, they're going to examine everything you did to determine if you committed a crime. And in reality, it winds up in the hands of the jury to find, were your actions justified in accordance with the law?
And in this case, it worked out for Dr. Turner.
Yes.
Thank you so much, Carl. We appreciate it. Well, during this entire case, our reporter, Jamont Terry, has been all over it from inside the courtroom. He has a look back now on the case from its start to the present.
You actually killed Jennifer D.
I don't deny it.
Just 2 days ago, Dr. Kirk Turner told the court he did kill his wife, Jennifer, but he insists he did so only to save his own.
Would you have otherwise ever done that?
No, never.
But Turner's own daughter, Wendy, told the court he was capable of intentionally killing the 54-year-old.
He said that there was 3 ways to get rid of the lawsuit: that my mother and father could reconcile, that my mother could drop the lawsuit, or that my mother could die.
The couple's son, Richie, also testified that his father never touched his mother and that Mrs. Turner wanted the children to choose sides.
She wanted me to take her side, to alienate me from my father.
Now Dr. Kirk Turner sits and waits at the defense table. He passes the time by reading the Bible. The future of this dentist lies in the hands of the 8 men and 4 women. The state and defense have presented its cases. Now the only thing left to do is wait.
Again, Dr. Kirk Turner, not guilty by reason of self-defense. That jury in Davie County finding him that way not too long ago. And you can continue to follow the whole trial right here on WXII 12 News and WXII12.com. We'll have more reaction from Moxville coming up throughout the day. Right now, we want to turn our attention to what's happening in our weather with Brian.
Yeah, strong storm front heading right to the area yesterday, Margaret. Things are certainly off to a quieter start today. You can actually see that we do have more weather out there.
Apparently, we have some trouble with Brian's microphone, and we're going to give him